Well, hello everyone. Welcome to Calm Sage. We are a happy community that is focusing on mental well-being. And today we'll be discussing about your confidence, how to be more confident and conquer your insecurities. And for that, we have a special guest over here, Miss Anjali.
Hello everyone, I'm Anjali Singh. I'm currently pursuing my PhD in psychology. Today, we'll be talking about insecurities and identify the underlying causes behind the same and have various fun activities that will help you eradicate your insecurities like a pro. To begin with, let us understand the concept of insecurity. Akansha, can you tell the audience what do you think about insecurity?
Of course. So, I don't know what is actually insecurity, but I would like to say that if I am wearing a dress, I am always insecure about my own body, about my own body shape, how I'm looking, and am I looking like Scarlett Johansson or not at the moment, or how will people think, how are they going to respond to my body shape. So yes, I am pretty much insecure about that, I guess.
Well, Akansha just gave you a brief what actually insecurity is about. In layman term, we can describe insecurity as any thought that has the power to shake your confidence. However, psychologically speaking, insecurity is an underlying emotion that shapes your overall self-esteem. But with this definition, it is also important to understand that insecurity is not a bracket or a bottle in which you can fit yourself. It is a concept that will vary from individual to individual, and each individual will have a different insecurity with a varying amount of intensity in him.
Okay, so I got your point, Anjali, but can you tell me a few more causes about insecurity? Why is it happening? Is it like my thoughts or what is the reason?
Okay, thank you for asking this question, Akansha. This is the next section that I was planning to cover as well, because the causes are important to understand, because once you understand the cause behind your insecurity, that is when you can work upon it. So, on the basis of process that an individual undergoes through, the insecurity aspect can be divided into three major domains. First is judge. When you judge yourself, that is the personal cause of insecurity. It is our own inner critic that thinks there is a shortcoming in myself. Maybe I am looking fat, maybe I'm not looking as well as a model is, or as well as my other colleagues are dressed up in the office or not. So this is the inner critic of yourself that is leading to the insecurity.
So do you think that if I'm having an insecurity about my own body and I'm thinking about how I'm looking, is it the insecurity, the personal insecurity you're talking about, right?
Yes, actually, because your own inner critic voice is criticizing you that you're not looking as good as a model, this dress is not fitting you. You know, no one else outside is saying you this thing, but your own critic voice is. So that leads to insecurity. Next is social. The social insecurity arises from the process of comparison. We human beings are social by nature, and we all belong to one society or the other. And with this society, there are certain norms attached which we all try to fit in. Right. And in this process, we are knowingly or unknowingly engaged in the process of comparing ourselves and like having one or the other insecurity.
Okay.
I read a very nice quote before coming. Mm-hmm. It says that we have struggled in conquering our insecurities because we are comparing our behind the scenes stories with someone else's life highlights, which shouldn't be the case.
Okay.
Moving further, the third major cause or major cause for insecurity is situation, and the process in which underlies this cause is evaluation. There are certain times when actually there is a situation in which you maybe fumbled or maybe didn't go as per your plans. So what you do is that you assume that this is something that I should be insecure about, right, or it didn't happen my way, so that leads to insecurity.
So tell us more about your
Well, now you know the cause of your insecurity. Before moving further, we'll have a fun activity so that it doesn't feel like, you know, a lecture or just an informational block thing happening.
Okay.
So yeah, I'm going to scroll down my finger through the viewers who have joined us. Mm-hmm. And the one on whom my finger will stop is supposed to share his or her dark or deepest secret with every one of us. I pick Monish from the list. So Monish, you're supposed to share your darkest and deepest secret with every one of us. But before you do that, I'm going to scroll my finger again and I'll pick one individual who will get a personal response for his or her query. It can be related to anything. Please feel free. For this, I'll choose...
Akshata, maybe?
Yeah, okay. Akshata, we choose you for this.
Yes.
Akshata, so you can ping me with any of your personal query, but Monish, you can relax because it was just a fun activity to show you that it's we, the individual, who give power to any event, situation or even our thoughts that could give a rise to any form of insecurity. Like here, you gave this little finger the power to make an insecurity or like a dark deep secret come to your eyes. So, but
it's okay, even I was scared, just like Monish could happen now, yes.
But the second point that I want to put forward is that why do we scared to share our deep dark secrets? We all have them, but the society norms doesn't allow us.
Right.
So the gist of this activity was that it is not an individual or society alone. Both of these factors go hand in hand in building and like, you know, managing an insecurity that an individual has.
Okay. Yeah. All right.